Civilization tried to destroy itself. The city degenerated into a total fear zone. The citizenry cocooning in their homes, afraid to go out. People just wanted the madness over.
Hey, hey, hey. Welcome to another Money Today. Well, I decided to do a deeper dive into Ethereum because I've actually never done an Ethereum video. And there are many reasons for that. I usually, when I decide to look into a coin, I go to Guy from Coin Bureau. Now, I don't know Guy, but I really love his research. I love the way he does videos, the way he explains things, his gorgeous voice. And, you know, I'm just generally on the same page as what he finds when I look through things. Although I usually go a bit deeper than him, he goes pretty deep. And I've watched his Ethereum videos, and 5 hours later, he has quite a few. I think we came to about the same conclusion.
Whew, wow, that was a long one. In case you dozed off anywhere during that video, here are a few closing thoughts. There are many people who are expressing their doubts about Ethereum right now. To be honest, I can't really blame them.
So, I went even, you know, further than Guy, of course, in, you know, through my own research. And what I even came, even a further realization, is it just doesn't matter. Ethereum has already won, and I think people kind of get it, but I'm going to slowly and methodically explain this conspiracy. And I do think they are conspiring to create a new form of everything, so that I guess that would fit conspiracy, but not as illegal.
I am the law!
I think most things that major that have happened, you know, tend to be something that was created by an insider group of people. Now, if you saw my video way back to March 30th, it was called Blockchain, You Can't Handle the Truth. And only 172 people saw that video, maybe 171, because I was probably one of them. Some really important things were discussed, and that was the history of the internet itself and how it was created. Wow, that sounds like a fun topic, doesn't it? But in the middle, you see right there, DARPA created the internet, ARPANET, with MIT and IBM, right? So, and this created pretty much all of the internet things. If we look back at Unix, which later becomes, you know, which goes into Linux and goes into Apple, basically everything. This is all, everything has been created off of this foundation. And why do I mention that? Well, it seems like that's what's going on with Ethereum today, that Ethereum is being built as the backbone for everything. And there may be a time when Ethereum is basically like a Oracle or something that nobody, or Apache or something that nobody even talks about or thinks about anymore. It's just in your computer, even a Unix, right? It's just something that's a backbone of your computer that nobody even mentions. And that could very well be Ethereum in 10 years. And, you know, all these layer two solutions end up becoming what we see every day. Now, I'm not certain about that. In fact, I'm not certain about most of the things here because it's the plan. Nobody's emailing me to let me know what the plan is. All I can do is kind of put things together on my own. And I think it's a pretty convincing. So if you remember, we go back to the early days of Windows even. I think history is repeating itself here. Now, there was a company, it's called GeoWorks. And truly, they were a better graphic user interface before Windows really came along. And somebody wrote back then, "I feel badly that this truly amazing program will never be given a chance, as IBM and Microsoft would never allow it." And that's kind of how I felt back then, I remember, because I liked GeoWorks. And then Windows came along and really never gave GeoWorks another shot. It was just over for them. And we're seeing that a lot now. And if we look at history there, we see Microsoft and IBM are both part of the Linux Foundation. So it seems, and then of course, we saw, you know, a couple weeks ago, I showed you that DARPA and the Linux Foundation are working together, you know, on 5G, the Internet of Things, Edge AI, all these sorts of things. So now we have this Defense Department public, quasi-public partnership that is building the foundations for everything that's going to be in our space. And I'm not going off of this one article. Most of you have seen my mind map. I will leave a link in the description below to this mind map so you can dig into it yourself. Now, yeah, it's pretty complicated. But given that I'm and all my videos are connected here, if you want to look up a subject, you can go in there and then you can look up the video for that subject. But given that I made all of these connections myself, I kind of understand where they all collide. And of course, that's with the Linux Foundation, with Hyperledger, Enterprise Ethereum Alliance. Now, Linux Foundation is mostly IBM. If you look at it, it's mostly IBM people. So what's old is new. And I told you that I would slowly go through this and show you. And this is a video on Ethereum. I'm showing you why Ethereum is the base of everything worldwide and in China, very much in China. And you're going to see the fingerprints of the Linux Foundation all over China and the rest of the world. But I just mentioned that because so people can truly understand this isn't an East-West thing. This is a worldwide thing. Everything is being built from the Linux Foundation, Hyperledger, and Ethereum. And I'm going to say that, period. Nothing else.
Doesn't anyone notice this? I feel like I'm taking crazy pills!
Now there'll be R3 involved in there. There'll be lots of other blockchains involved in there. So I'm not saying these are the only players. I'm saying this is the basis for everything. So let's slowly go through that. And let me show you what I mean. First of all, just in case you were thinking like Enterprise or Ethereum and Hyperledger are two different things. Hyperledger is the private and Ethereum is public and they don't really coexist. Well, you see right away with the Enterprise Ethereum Alliance that these two are joined at the hip. And if you want to, you know, I'll leave this in the description, you can read through it. These basically companies saying how they're going to work with each other. The two organizations will contribute to accelerating mass adoption of blockchain technologies for business. So we're looking at these two working together. And then if you go to another video of mine, which is the Ethereum Mafia. And you see, when Ethereum was created, so many of the people who were involved in Ethereum are still involved with Ethereum. They're just going through different ways of representing it with different companies, such as Polkadot, such as Consensus. And, you know, maybe Cardano would be the only one that I think is any way outside of Ethereum. Everybody else is working to make Ethereum better. And so we'll mention Joseph Lubin here with Consensus, who was a part of Ethereum, also a major part of the Enterprise Ethereum Alliance, and also runs Consensus. And from Consensus, you get Baseline and Unibright. JP Morgan is on the board of Consensus, and Quorum, which you may hear later on, is JP Morgan, but now that's part of Consensus. So you can see this is all put together. And maybe you've heard of MetaMask, the wallet. Well, that was developed by Consensus. So you're starting to see there's a major Ethereum hub right there. And I'll show you a little proof of that. It says right here, developer Consensus for MetaMask. And then you will see, you know, many articles showing ConsenSys joins Hyperledger as a premier member. So ConsenSys promoting Ethereum at a very basic level with Baseline and everybody else. Also, one of the guys we talk about all the time, David Treat, just a member of everything here. Between Accenture, the Chamber of Digital Commerce, the Digital Dollar Foundation, the World Economic Forum, and Hyperledger, Enterprise Ethereum Alliance, David Treat is connected to all of it. And we see here he is tweeting about Hyperledger Cactus as a framework to make it easier to maintain software operates across different distributed ledgers. Well, what distributed ledgers are we looking at? Hyperledger, Corda, Corda OS, Hyperledger Fabric, Go Ethereum, Quorum, Hyperledger Sawtooth. Interesting group there, isn't it? It just across all the ones we just talked about. And what is Go Ethereum? Is that Ethereum? Go Ethereum is one of the three original implementations of the Ethereum protocol. So it is connected there to Ethereum. And now I promised you that I would talk about the China part. Inside China's effort to create a blockchain it can control. We always hear that, you know, China creates its own thing within its own, and this is not a Western thing, but I've showed you over and over and over how the West's technology is all over the Chinese blockchain and is very, very deeply connected. And it's very deeply connected to the Linux Foundation and Hyperledger, which are both major part of the BSN, which is the Chinese blockchain. Both local and global developers, both local, which means inside China, and global, will also be offered Baidu's Xuperchain, FiscGo, a blockchain product by the Chinese bank WeBank, founded by Tencent. Now, we see that's WeBank, Tencent, and Huawei, right? Which is Linux Foundation, all Linux Foundation people. So there's already the local and global can use a Linux Foundation, or they can use Hyperledger, or Quorum, JP Morgan, ConsenSys, right? So we're seeing again, and this was their first partner was, of course, Ethereum for worldwide. So once again, those same players. And as I told you, FiscGo BIOS launched in 2017, and that is WeBank, Tencent, and Huawei. Well, we can look right there. There's WeBank, and then Tencent, and there is Huawei. And these are huge in the Linux Foundation, obviously, platinum members. And then if you want to look at them all together here in Hyperledger Caliper, which serve as a reference between using the following blockchain solutions. Again, Hyperledger, Hyperledger, Ethereum, FiscGo BIOS, basically the Chinese blockchain, and Hyperledger. And Ethereum, of course. Wherever you go, what you see is this connection between the Linux Foundation, Hyperledger, and Ethereum, building the fundamental building blocks throughout the entire world. Now, you can build anything you want on top of that. And in China, of course, it would have to be approved, but you're already approved with people like Algorand or Polkadot or, you know, several other chains. But the foundations, when you get right back to it, are going to be the Linux Foundation and Ethereum running, everything running on that worldwide. And I found this to be true over and over and over. And the supporting cast for that, you're going to find people like ConsenSys and Baseline. And frankly, you know, members that were high up in IBM. And we've talked many times about Brian Behlendorf, who is in charge of the Linux Foundation, who also was the COO of the World Economic Forum. You know, I've mentioned that before and I keep mentioning it. Now I think I've explained it slowly and shown you that over and over and over, these connections are happening throughout the world. You know, we're going to see it through the IMF. We're going to see it through the World Bank. We're going to see it through the Bank of International Settlements. We're going to see it through the major banks. We're going to see it through Visa and MasterCard. And everybody is going to be connected to these few companies. And it's going to come out as open source and all kinds of things. You're going to hear all these banking the unbanked and all these wonderful terms. But when it comes down to it, the basics for all of it are going to be rooted in these few companies. Let's take a step back again and remember what we're talking about. We're talking about Ethereum. Or should you invest in Ethereum? And even to this point, after all of this research, and I say Ethereum is going to be at the base of everything in the entire world, it would seem like a no-brainer great investment. But I want to hold back there for a second. Just because it's going to be the base for everything doesn't mean this coin is going to be worth anything. Now, it probably will. It will probably be worth, you know, it will probably be the new Google or Tesla or whatever, or even more than that. But it also might not, because they're coming out with new rules and new forks and new things for Ethereum that most people have never even heard of that have the potential to make Ethereum worthless or make Ethereum invaluable. And we don't know whether these are going to be approved or not. And we think that it's going to be done by a consensus of people who own Ethereum. That may be true. I really have no idea. It's like I said, if you want to go and watch all of Guy's videos, you're going to come out as confused as he was. It's a very confusing timeline. And it doesn't seem like it's any hurry. And that might just be fine. Do I own Ethereum? I do. I think it would almost seem crazy after what I just showed you that you wouldn't at least have part of your portfolio in Ethereum. It's just too much intertwined into every single thing going on. But will the, you know, in the end, what do I expect? Maybe a huge shakeout, try and get everybody off of Ethereum so they could buy it up. If you're going to own Ethereum, just hold it. Just put it away. Don't ever look at it. You may have to have some that you have for like buying and selling, you know, so you can pay the gas fees or whatever. But have your certain amount that just there's nothing that's going to make you spend that or use it. That's what I'm personally doing. And I really don't know what else to say. There's no perfect science here. Unless you're an insider and knows what's actually going on, in my opinion. Now, if you know something I don't know, for goodness sakes, let the rest of us know, or at least me. Go to my Twitter or leave a comment below and let me know what you think. I think it's a fascinating subject, and I think just the amount of information that's right here in front of us that almost nobody knows. Let somebody like a guy who does this for a living and does this research doesn't even either notice or talk about. But it's not like he leaves. It's not like he doesn't go there with a lot of subjects, but this is a particular one that I've never really heard him talk about. So anyways, I really appreciate you. Leave your comments below, subscribe, all that stuff. And I hope you'll learn something here. All right. After this episode, I'm going to probably go back to looking at particular coins. I'm guessing in my next episode, I am going to go over the coins that I'm holding and why very quickly. After that, I'm probably going to go into more specifics. PolkaSwap just came out. There's more Definity news, more Algorand news, and you know, I kind of want to get back into them. And let's see what's going on with Stellar. Anyways, love y'all. And I'll see you.